Good morning. It's your Tuesday morning meeting for Thanksgiving week 2010, and I'll try and make this quick. So first of all, we've got two new listings this week. We've got 276 Yarborough. It was just taken yesterday on Monday by Kate and Ron. It's out by the airport. It's I don't even have the square footage in front of me. I believe it's 174,000. Huge lot, big home, built to withstand just about any storm. Anything that a storm could throw with it, so it's a really special property, very beautiful on the inside, and nice big lot, fence yard, well taken care of, fairly new if I recall. I'll have something on the website about it this week, but just to let you know it's there, just in case you're looking for someone that's looking for a big strong house out by the airport. Second thing is 6801 West Seacove. It's just off 206 on Seacove Avenue. I'm not sure if I covered this one last week or not. I'm not sure if it was in by Tuesday or not. But this is a $199,000 listing. It's got a heated pool. It's got a three-car garage. It's on a half-acre lot. Interior of the home looks immaculate. We should be getting some video on it this week or next week, depending on what the seller's schedule is like. So look for that on the website. But the virtual tour is already up. So you can see the inside of the house. You can see the garage. You can see the pool. You can see the lot. It's a really cool home. And it's literally just minutes to Crescent Beach. It's probably no more than 3 miles of Crescent Beach, might even be less. So that's 10 minutes by bicycle and probably 3 minutes by car. One cool thing that last week we kind of covered the new videos we're doing for the website. We'll be talking in the next week or two about I talked about the QR code too, and we started putting QR codes into practice this week on our flyers, sending them to our sellers, doing a lot of other things, and having some fun with them to see how the QR codes interact differently on Blackberries versus iPhones and Android phones. But that's for the future, and we'll show you how to put a QR code together in a new training video pretty soon. But the thing I'm doing this week is called, it's a tool called DocuSign. And DocuSign is basically a web service where you can take your listing contracts or your purchase and sale contracts that are already on your computer. You know how you, either you pull them off floridarealtors.org in a form of simplicity, and they're on your computer, or you might get a sales contract from another agent via fax, and you can e-fax them on a machine here to yourself, so you have an electronic document. But anyway, you can take these electronic documents, whatever they are, a PDF, Word file, Excel file, or whatever, and what DocuSign does is it packages them all in a single group, and gives you little tabs that you can kind of drag over and put on the contract where you need it signed, or where you need it initialed, or where it needs to be dated, etc. And what this does is it sends it to your buyer or seller. They establish an electronic signature with DocuSign, and then all they need to do is click in each place where it needs to be initialed or signed, and then they can email it back to you. It never has to be printed out, which is really cool, because that's part of the reason I'm doing this is because I've got a customer in Aruba this week who's trying to sell his house, and the faxes just aren't getting to him, and honestly my phone calls aren't getting to him either, so we're not sure how his internet contact is or his internet capability is, but we've been able to talk periodically on email, so I'm hoping that he goes to his inbox and he will see a document there from DocuSign, and all he has to do is click on it to assign it and initial it, and then as soon as he's done doing that, it'll automatically get sent back to me, and then I can give it back to the agent who presented the offer. So it's a really cool tool. It's great if you even just have customers across town. Instead of driving a single paper all the way up to the north side of the city off State Route 16, or driving it out to Hastings, or you know, you're in a hurry and maybe the drive isn't that far, but you don't have time to do it, or it's going to be, you know, it really takes you out of your way from what you're trying to accomplish in the day, you can have it electronically and email it to the person, and they can email it right back to you in a couple minutes, and you don't drive and you save gas. It's just absolutely perfect. It costs $20 a month, and so I've got it signed up for myself. I got the impression that you could sign up the company for $20 a month. I still have to look into that, but they wanted to charge me $200 a month, and we're not using it right now to bear that cost. So for $20 a month, heck, $20 for one shot to send it to Aruba was cheaper than overnighting anything. So it's a really good deal. It's a realtor. NAR has a special discount on it, so I got like $5 a month off because it's an NAR supplier. Last two things. If it is to be, it's up to me. Part of what we're doing is always trying to push the envelope honorably, legally, ethically. always trying to find new ways, innovative ways to catch the public's attention and to create sales. By pushing the envelope legally, honorably, ethically, one of the things like we did last month and was you list with us and we sell the house, we'll make a donation to breast cancer research. Well, we're making our first donation to breast cancer research this week, actually today as we speak. It's going to be a $100 donation, $75 from the corporate side, and $25 personally is going to go to breast cancer research on a sale we did with a buyer at 831 Vista Cove. Didn't necessarily advertise for buyers, but we got a buyer, went under contract in October, and what the heck, let's send it to breast cancer research. But that's the way you push the envelope. We want to do this anyway. We want to donate to breast cancer research anyway, but if we're going to do it anyway, let's figure out a way to get the public, engage the public too, and get them on our side, and this is a great way to do it. And we actually had a realtor call Kate and was very upset that we were using the pink ribbon, you know, and so, you know, when I write that $100 check tomorrow, or $100 worth of checks this morning, I hope she chokes on it. Because this really is a good thing that we are doing. No other company donates corporate dollars that we're aware of to foundations like that, at least not locally. Not even Big Red, White, and Blue down the street. That's it. So anyway, that's it. If it is to be, it's up to me. In other words, we're looking for new ways to push the envelope legally, honorably, ethically. You look for new ways to push the envelope legally, honorably, ethically. Make connections with your customers. Use DocuSign that'll blow them out of the water when they're expecting this big ream of paperwork to come in the mail. You got an out-of-town seller. And all of a sudden it's like, no, I can add a listing paperwork to you in an hour. And you just need to click on it and I can have it back in an hour and we can get your thing on the market. I don't have to send it up to Atlanta. You get it in 2 days. I'll get it back in 4 days. By then a buyer might have already came through the market and left. In this case, you know, that's one thing to wow your buyers with. Doing things like our pink ribbon donations is another way to wow your buyers or sellers. So video is another way. So engage them sellers. Keep looking for ways and we will help you any way we can. Happy Thanksgiving. Have a great one. Drive safe. Enjoy your turkey. Enjoy the nap after you eat the turkey. And enjoy the football this weekend. And have a great time. And we'll see you next week. Thank you for being our agents. You're the best agents in the business. We appreciate it.